Good afternoon, everyone. Myself, Amit Kanujia, and my group members are Daksh Asher and Rahul Pariyar. Today, we are going to present the experiment number 5 of Computational Lab 1, that is, explore web application vulnerabilities using open source tools like WebPT Browser Exploitation Framework. Next. Web application vulnerabilities originate from users' indiscriminate trust in the input data. Vulnerabilities are nothing but the system flaws, loopholes, or weakness in the web-based application that can be exploited by the malicious users. So the developers of the web application have to be aware how the user input interfere with the control flow or output of the application. Not doing so can lead to the attack of malicious user on the web application. Next. Now, what is WebPT? WebPT is a tool used to identify the vulnerabilities in the web-based application. It was created in 2006 by Nicholas Suribas and later contributed by Jasper from 2008. It is written in Python language. It allows users to audit the security of his system or web-based application. It uses black box testing approach. It is a method of software security testing in which the security controls, defense, and design of an application are tested with little or no prior knowledge of the application internal working. It means that it does not scan the entire source code. Once it gets the list of all URLs, forms, and the input, it acts like a fuzzer or injecting payload to see if the scripts are vulnerable. Fuzzer is a program which injects automatically random data into the program to find the bug, and payloads are the set of malicious code so that it performs attack on the website to identify whether it is vulnerable or not. Next. The general features of WebPT is that it generates report in various formats such as HTML, XML, JSON, or text file. It can even suspend and resume an attack or a scan. It provides various colors in the terminal to highlight various vulnerabilities. It is fast and easy way to activate attack modules. Adding a payload is also easy as adding a line in a text file. Now the next slide will be explained by Rahul Pariyar.
Flaws detected by the WebPT tool are cross-site scripting, SQL injection, command execution detection. Cross-site scripting attack occurs when an attacker uses a web application to send a malicious code. Generally, this code is in the form of browser side script. SQL injection attack, in which attacker can gain a complete access to all the data in the database server. Command injection attacks are possible when an application passes unsafe user supply data, that is, form, cookies, or HTTP headers to the system side. Attack module used by the WebPT tool are first backup. This model will search the backup of all the scripts on the server. Blind SQL means it will scan the SQL without any prior knowledge of SQL. EXE, this module used by the WebPT to detect the command execution vulnerabilities. Other modules used by the WebPT tool are file, htaccess, SQL, cross-site scripting. Next. Advantages and disadvantages. Advantages of using this tool is user don't need any security knowledge and it is very fast and accurate. Also, new attack can be added in an easy way. Disadvantages of using this tool, it is not able to find all the vulnerabilities. Demonstration will be done by Daksh.
So now we have an overview of what WebPT is. WebPT is basically a tool that is used to scan a website to find the vulnerabilities. It performs a set of the attacks that we have seen in the PPTs. So starting with the installation of the WebPT, so you can go on this website, that is webpt.sourcefrog.io. Here you can see the download WebPT option. So you can click on and download the WebPT tool. It will give you a zip file. So just open the folder in which you have that zip file. So I have my zip file here. You can see wapti.master.zip file. So extract this file. After extracting this file, you can go inside that file and see these files here. So here the important file is setup.py file, by which we will install Wapti on our Windows machine. In Linux machine, it comes by default, but for Windows, we have to install it on our machine. And the dependency to work on the Wapti is Python environment. So I am using the Anaconda to set up the Python environment. So the CMD by Anaconda has already the Python environment, so I will use it. So first we have to go inside this folder in order to install this Wapti by CMD. So currently I am in the C folder. Okay, so now I have reached inside that folder where all the files were present. So starting the installation, I will write the command python space setup.py space install. So by executing this command, it will install Wapti on our Windows machine. So now the Wapti is installed in our system. If you are unsure, you want to check again that Wapti is installed properly, then you can just write Wapti. So it will show you the screen. If it is not installed properly or there is some error, then it won't show this. So as discussed in the previous slides, there are some modules in the Wapti. So if you want to see those modules, then you can write the command Wapti space dash dash list. So by executing this command, you can see all the modules that are present. That is backup module, blind SQL module, file module, htaccess module. So these are the set of modules that are present in the Wapti. So starting the attack that Wapti used to perform, it is used to scan the website. So in order to perform that scanning, I will write Wapti space dash u, that is URL, and the next I would have to enter the website name, sorry, website URL. So I will go to the website. So you have to enter the URL of that website. Once you execute this command, it will start performing all the attacks. Since I have previously performed this attack, so you can see here it skips some of the attacks since the session is again resumed. Therefore, it shows skipped. So this will take more time to execute. Therefore, I will directly show you the report. Once it is executed, it will show you the URL of the location where it has saved the HTML file. It generates the report file in many formats, XML, HTML, but by default, it is in the HTML format. So we will see the file that it has generated. So this is the file that it has generated. It shows the number of the vulnerabilities for that particular attack. So SQL injection shows 9 vulnerabilities for that attack. Similar for blind SQL, file handling, and much more. If you want to check which are those 9 problems or vulnerabilities, then you can click on the SQL injection link and you can see all the 9 vulnerable problems. Also, if you want to check in more detail, then you can visit the location of the URL that is given. So by entering the URL, you will come to know what is the problem, what is the warning that it gives. Also, it gives the line number where the problem has occurred. So it is more helpful. Also, the next thing is the by default, the WebT performs all the attacks that it has predefined modules. So there are around 10 to 15 attacks that it is used to perform directly. So if we want only some particular attack to perform, maybe as SQL or only cross-site scripting, then we have to switch the module. So I will show you the command by which you can perform those attacks. So here you can see the command webt-u and space the URL dash m and then the attack that I want to perform. SQL, if there are multiple attacks, then you have to enter comma, space that attack. If I only want to perform one, then I will remove this and only SQL. So I will copy and execute on our command line. So I need to once again start. So now I will execute. At the end, it will generate a report similar to that we have seen here. It will also show a set of the attacks that are vulnerable, but it will show only SQL attacks. So that is it. Thank you for watching our presentation.
Can you show that report?
Just a second. So this is the location where it stores. There are already many websites, so it's pretty confusing. New one.
You can arrange the folder according to the dates. So the latest one will be.
Because sometimes of the network issue, it also shows zero errors, so zero vulnerabilities. So it also depends on the network, the execution process. And it takes time, around 5 to 10 minutes to execute. So that was it from our side.
Oh.